Hello and welcome to my channel and welcome to this video. My name is Emma and today's video is a chatty catch-up style video. I'm going to share with you some of the things that I've been making over the last few weeks, some of the things that I've finished and some plans as well for things that I want to make over the next few months probably. So thank you so much for being here and for spending a bit of your precious time with me. I really appreciate it. Welcome if you're a new subscriber. It's really lovely to have you here. Thank you for taking a chance and pressing that subscribe button on my channel. It's so lovely. And a massive thank you to those of you who've been with me for a while, and some of you for a really long time. You are so appreciated as well. So how are you? I really hope that you are well. Wherever you are in the world, I hope you're enjoying the season that you're in. We've just started autumn here and the temperature has dropped and it's starting to get a bit cozy, and I'm really going to try and embrace it this year because it's usually a time of year I struggle with. But my son is really excited about autumn decor. He's been telling me to decorate the house for autumn. So I'm going to try and make a few autumn things, I think, over the next 2 months, so hopefully that'll be something I'll be able to share with you. So I've got quite a few things to share today, so this might be a bit of a long video, I'm sorry about that. Got quite a lot to say about the things that I've made. So the big finish for me this month was the penguin quilt, which I've showed you little bits of in the past, but here it is. I'll just hold it up. In fact, I'll stand up, stand back a bit so you can see. So we've got four penguins on each row. That was the top row, middle row, and at the bottom as well. And I'm so happy with how this came out. And I'm going to share with you a few things that I did that really made this probably one of the best machine pieced quilts that I've made. The backing is this lovely fabric which I think is called Arctic Animals, and it's by Dashwood Studios. I'll leave a link to as much as I can in the description box, so I'll try and find the fabric and link it. It's perfect because the colours in the fabric are perfect coordination with the colours that I've used on this side. And I keep forgetting to mention, but the pattern, the penguin quilt pattern, is by Elizabeth Hartman, and I'll leave a link to that below as well. So yeah, it turned out really great. I'm really happy with the binding because that coordinates really well with the gingham penguins. So it's all crumpled because it has been used ever since it was gifted to my son, and he really, really loves it. He said he's going to keep it forever and then give it to his baby, which I just thought was the perfect response. Now, when it comes to making quilts, I think the thing that I struggle with the most is the layering up of the quilt sandwich and then basting it all before doing the actual quilting. And what has tended to happen to me in the past is I've ended up with puckers on the front and back in certain places, and I always end up a bit frustrated by that stage, and sometimes it feels like all your hard work that goes into the piecing can be a bit ruined sometimes by the quilting. So I think that's a sort of natural thing because you get a lot more practice of the piecing than you do of the quilting. That's the case for me anyway. So I did what I usually do. I put the backing fabric right side down onto the floor and I taped around the edges with masking tape, and I used a spray based to spray it and then put the wadding on, and then I sprayed it again and put the quilt top on, and that was all fine. It's a very exhausting process. I forgot how tiring basting a quilt is, but anyway, that was all fine. It seemed to be nice and flat. And of course, I'd pressed everything before doing that. But when I lifted it from the floor, I realised that there was some ripples and that they would probably end up being puckers. So what I actually did was pressed it with an iron at that stage, and I pressed it on the back and also the front, and I pressed it from the centre outwards. And I just think that made a world of difference, because I ended up with no puckers at all. And I did very loosely quilt it, which I think also helps. Because there's just more space and the fabric can relax a bit more. But I think I would absolutely recommend pressing your quilt after the basting stage, because everything sort of shifted outwards and it just became much flatter, and I think it made a world of difference. Now, this isn't a big quilt, so it's possible with a quilt of this size or maybe a bit bigger, but huge quilts, it would be very difficult to do that. But that's definitely something I'm going to do again. Now, in terms of the actual quilting, so I just used my sewing machine and a walking foot, and it worked really, really well. But I used a thread that I have never used before for quilting. I used Wonderfil Deco Bob, because they don't just sell it in the bobbins for the for your bottom thread. They also sell it in larger reels for your top thread. And I watched a really interesting YouTube video made by Wonderfil all about their Deco Bob thread, and I learned a lot more about that thread than I already knew. And I'll leave a link to that video, because if you're interested in trying that thread, or if you've got it already and you're interested in what else can you do with it, because it is much more than a bobbin thread. That's what I learned from that video. In fact, I'm going to start using it for piecing, because in their video they show what a difference it can make with your seam allowance, and that your seams can be much flatter because Deco Bob is an 80 weight thread and takes up much less space. And they show a comparison with probably a standard 50 weight cotton thread compared to the Deco Bob, and there was a really big difference, and I thought that would really benefit me in making my seams more accurate. So that's something I'm going to try next time I make a machine pieced quilt. But I used it for the quilting, and the reason I did that was because I wanted a grey thread that would just blend in really well, and I just knew that this would. I didn't want the quilting to be really obvious. I did diagonal lines. There's one of the quilting lines, if you can see. I just did diagonal lines in one direction, 3 inches apart, and I did it like that because two reasons. I wanted it to be a snuggly quilt and not a really dense quilt, but also I didn't want too much quilting to go over the penguins' faces. So the most any penguin has is 2 lines of stitching over the face, so I was happy about that. And I think it worked out really well, and the wadding I used said the maximum space between quilting stitches needed to be 3.5 inches, so I was within that, so that all worked out really great. And I would definitely use the Deco Bob for quilting again. And like I said, I'm going to try it for piecing as well. So I think I learned quite a lot from making this quilt. And the other thing I learned is I actually do enjoy machine sewing. I, for a long time, had been a bit put off it, but I really enjoyed making this. So I'm going to carry on with machine sewing and have probably just one machine piece quilt on the go, as well as my other more hand-stitched projects. So if you have any questions about the quilt, anything that I haven't covered that you'd like to know, then do leave them in the comments below. But if you're interested in making this, then I really recommend it. There are lots of little pieces, but if you label everything and do it in an organized way, then you'll be able to do it. If I can do it, you can do it. So I would definitely attempt something a bit more complex next time. It's given me a bit of confidence, and it's really fun, and it's a great quilt. I mean, what child isn't going to love to get a penguin quilt? So if you're looking for a gift for a child in your life, then highly recommend this one. So my next projects are little purses, really. So a lovely shop called Oh So Sweet, that I bought this kit from them at Festival of Quilts. So it was the pattern, and it came with the clasp as well, the purse clasp, to make this little sewing box. And they very kindly gifted me the fabric that they didn't have it available on their stall at Festival of Quilts, and I wanted to use this cheetah print, and they very kindly gifted me this for the inside as well, which was just so kind of them. They have a really lovely shop and I'll leave a link to that below. So I was very keen to make it, and I haven't made a lot of things with clasps before, a few projects, but they can be a bit tricky, and I was nervous with using the glue and things, but it turned out really great. So here it is. I followed the pattern exactly. I guess the only thing I did differently was, if you can see, so I've used that cheetah print, the patchwork print, for the outer part of the, they're calling it a sewing box. And the only thing I did differently was that I actually quilted that without the lining. So I just quilted it to the wadding, and I used a 12 weight thread in my sewing machine to try and make it look a bit like hand stitching. And it turned out really nicely. The stitches are, I don't know if you can see that, there we go. The stitches turned out really nicely on top. They show up just the right amount. And yeah, so another experiment with different threads in the sewing machine. 12 weight thread worked really well. I didn't use 12 weight in the bobbin, just used a normal 50 weight in the bobbin. So it opens up like this, and then we have this inside, and it has some pockets here. And it's just really lovely. And like I said, I was worried about putting the clasp on, because that is the most, that's the trickiest part, but actually it wasn't tricky. It was actually okay. And now I have this lovely little little purse, sewing case, so it can fit all sorts of things in there. You can never have too many of those. So that was a really fun project. I really enjoyed making it, and I'm definitely going to get some more of these clasps so I can use the pattern again, because it was really easy to make. I think next time, rather than just using wadding and iron-on interfacing, I'll try it with the foam that I usually use for my sewing cases and things like that. It's a 1/4 inch thick foam, and I didn't use it for this because I was worried it would be too thick, but there's lots of space in that clasp, and I think it would definitely fit in there. I'm going to try that next time, and that would just give it a bit more stability. You can see it's a bit squishy, which is fine, but I like the definition that you get from using the foam, either the sew-in foam or the double-sided fusible foam. That's probably what I would use for this. So yeah, really pleased with how that turned out. The fabric is from the same shop, Oh So Sweet, but it is poppy cotton, and I have some of the salvage left here. It says, "My Favourite Things" by Aaliyah Lutz, and it's poppy cotton. I love poppy cotton. I bought a whole stack of poppy cotton fabrics from Oh So Sweet that I'm going to use in my Quilt As You Go quilt, and for other things as well. So the same shop, Oh So Sweet, also gifted me this pattern, which is the sew-in bauble purse. I keep wanting to say bubble, bauble purse. Now this one is even easier than the last one because you don't need any glue for it. You sew the clasp in. And I really enjoyed making this, and I want to get some more of these clasps and make more. I used Liberty for the lining, this really sweet Liberty print. So it's such a small purse, it's great for scraps. And I also embroidered it with a vintage embroidery transfer. So what I did was I took the transfer, I used my light box to trace it onto the fabric, and once I'd done that, I used some new to me thread actually, which I'm going to have in my shop very soon. And it's a Lana wool acrylic blend thread, a 12 weight thread made by Wonderfil. I just thought it'd be really nice to try it out to see what it's like, and I really love the effect that you get with it. It's really great to stitch with. It didn't tangle once, and it gives that sort of cozy effect because it's wool. I don't know if that makes any sense, but it's a lovely texture. It's different to using embroidery thread, which embroidery thread is really lovely too. It just depends what sort of feel that you want, but I really enjoyed using this. I think it's great for simple embroidery projects, and the colours are so pretty, so I thought, well, I'll stock some in my shop because I love it, and that's the way I run my shop. I just put the things in there that I absolutely love. So they'll be there. If they're not there now, they'll be there as soon as they arrive, and I also have a few other things restocked in my shop as well. So I've been busy updating that. So yeah, so I can really recommend this little purse pattern. It's the instructions for both of these patterns are really clear and really simple to follow, and it's just a really fun little project. So a while ago I showed you a crochet project that I was making. I was using two strands of this lovely cotton bamboo yarn, which is made by Stylecraft, and I was using two strands of that to make what it was intended to be, a drawstring bag for the summer, and I wanted to put some embroidery on it and to line it with Liberty. But as I went along, I started to think, oh, it's not summer anymore and I'm probably not going to use this as a bag. And in the end, and the other reason was I was starting to run out of the yarn. I thought, I don't have enough to make it as big as I want it to be for a bag. I'd have to buy two more balls, but I wouldn't use the whole of those. Then what would I do with the leftovers? So I've ended up stopping and turning it into a bowl, which now it looks like this. And I've ended up with leftovers still, so I didn't solve that problem. But I'll tell you about the yarn in a minute. But this is the crochet bowl. So I added some embroidery onto the front of it. I used the same yarn from the range, Stylecraft cotton bamboo, or bamboo cotton. It's a DK yarn. And I lined it with this lovely coordinating Liberty print. And I'm really pleased with how it turned out. And I'm glad I stopped when I did. And this will be really nice. I tend to use these sort of things in the sewing room, just throwing things in. So straight away, they're just really useful for putting a lot of things inside to tidy up the space. So I don't know what else have I got. Threads, big threads, anything really. You can just pop it in and straight away, everything is nice and neat. It looks a lot better than just tossed around. So that's what I'm going to use it for. I just did a double crochet stitch. I just did a circle increasing until it was the size that I wanted. And then I just went round and round and round until it was the height that I wanted it to be. And yeah, it's a fun little crochet bowl. So I'll just show you the embroidery. So the idea for the embroidery, I'd already thought about doing some embroidery, but then I came across this book, which is called Embroidered Crochet. And so I thought, well, I'll have to get that book because this is what I've been thinking about doing for this project. And the book actually comes with transfers that you can use your iron to transfer it to the crochet, which I was really dubious about because I've had bad experiences with iron-on transfers before, and I just thought, really, is it going to actually take? Is the yarn going to take the design? Would it actually work? And it did. It worked perfectly. So that made embroidering the design really, really straightforward. So the yarn that I used for the crochet bowl was the Stylecraft cotton bamboo, as I mentioned. I've just I'll just rip this one. It's come out all in a mess with a hook. Anyway, there's the label of what it looks like. Cotton bamboo. And it comes in really lovely colours. I used these two colours held double, so one strand of each to make the basket. And then to do the embroidery, I used some other colours from the range. I did attempt to use the Appleton's Crewel wool, but it was far too fine. So, and the book does recommend using the same yarn that you make the project from to do the embroidery, and that just worked brilliantly. But what I love about this range of yarns is that they have really lovely muted colours. So I ended up, I bought quite a lot of them because I was planning on making a blanket with them. So there's the sort of lemon colour. And I've got a grey and a peach. Yeah, lots of colours. Lovely muted pastel colours. And it's so, so soft as well. So I really do recommend this yarn. I think it's really nice. It's not too expensive. Oh, there's a blue as well, which I haven't used yet. So I did want to make some sort of blanket with it, even though I already have blankets on the go. But I did actually start to make a bit of a practice motif, but I found it to be quite a loose gauge, and I do think this yarn is definitely on the finer side. It's not, doesn't feel like a typical DK really. It feels a bit thinner, and but it's so soft, it would make a really great cardigan. So I have lots of colours. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet, whether I will make some sort of blanket if I alter my hook size and make it a bit of a tighter gauge. I don't know. I'm not in a rush to decide about that anyway, but it is, it's all coming unravelled a bit, but it is really lovely yarn. So yeah, I do recommend that, and I'll leave a link if I can find one to where you can find that, and then you can read all about it there. This book is so good. I think I would want to make pretty much everything in this book. I mean, I absolutely love this blanket because it's got the birds on it and flowers. Let's see if I can find a close-up. It's called Birds and Trees. Sorry, not flowers, Birds and Trees. But there's another one in here that's got really pretty flowers. Yes, those. Wildflower wall hanging. It's got Lily of the Valley on it. So I really recommend this book if you want to do a bit of crochet and add some embroidery to it, for two reasons. The designs are lovely, and also you get the transfers in the back that you can cut out and they iron onto your project, and they work brilliantly. So 10 out of 10 recommend that. So another project finished, and I think I will be making more things directly out of this book because, yeah, I really love them. So that's it for finished things. And all of those things were projects that I was making for fun, not my designs or ideas, just things to make as a hobby, because when you turn your hobby into a business, it can be quite easy to lose your hobby. So I really try and make sure that I'm making something for fun, as well as something for content or patterns and things. I'm trying to make sure I do both, because although making the content and making patterns and designing things is definitely fun, and I'm really lucky and grateful that I can call this my job, there is a bit of a pressure to it, in that it's got to be finished by a certain time. I have a camera in front of me filming myself, and that's not the most relaxing way to create. So because of that, I really am trying to make sure I keep making things for fun as well. It's important. So a little update on my patterns. So you may have seen that I released last month my pattern for the Little House Notion pouch. These are the two that I made. So if you've bought that pattern, thank you so much. I really hope that you're going to love making it just as much as I did. It's a really great little pouch that you can fit a reel of thread, you can fit small scissors inside it, you can put your needles or pins up there, and it's super cute. And you can embellish it as well, so you can add whatever you want to the front and back and yeah, make it your own, or you can just keep it as it is. a massive thank you to everybody who supported me by buying that pattern. And I'm still working on my bigger version. So this was the prototype, and I've had to go back to the drawing board numerous times over this, but there will be a pattern for a bigger version. I'm just really ironing out the kinks and making sure that it's going to be the best pattern that it can possibly be. So I'm hoping to get that done in the next few weeks, but we'll see. These things are a slow process at times, they take a long time, but hopefully worth the wait. So plans for things coming up. So I'm planning to finish the Jane Austen inspired quilt that I made that you might have seen in my last video. I'm going to add another row of diamonds and then another border to that, and I'll show you that when that is finished. I haven't worked on that again yet, but I'm really excited and keen to get that one done. And I'm not sure how I'm going to quilt it yet. I might machine quilt it just to use it as a bit of practice, and also because it's quicker. But I did buy another Jane Austen themed project kit, and it is this box. So it's the Sense and Sensibility by box, inspired by that story, and it's the Barton Cottage quilt kit, and it's by Riley Blake, and it's using the Jane Austen at home fabric, so the exact replicas of the ones that are in her coverlet that I went to see. And this is the quilt pattern. You might have seen this. They are actually just bringing out the Pride and Prejudice one, but these quilts kits are not cheap, and the Pride and Prejudice one is definitely well out of my price range, but I managed to get this one for pretty much half price, and I really love the design. I'm really excited to make it because it's a house, obviously. and Sense and Sensibility is definitely one of my favourite stories. I love it. It's really hard to pick a favourite, but that's probably between that one and Pride and Prejudice. I think I would be leaning towards Sense and Sensibility maybe as my favourite, but I do love Emma, so yeah. I got this for nearly half price, and the place that I bought it from, they don't have any more left. And the reason why it was nearly half price was because the box, it said the box was damaged, and now I obviously wanted the box because it is such a lovely thing to have on display, and there weren't any pictures of it online. I just took a chance and ordered it because I thought to myself, well, if the box is damaged, it's not the end of the world, it's really more about the quilt kit inside. But the damage to the box is really minimal. I think maybe if you'd paid full price you might be a bit upset about the damage, but I certainly wasn't. So you can just see there's just this little mark on the front. There's a few little, I don't know if you can see, yeah, little dents in it. Really, that's the only damage. Nothing is ripped. It's just dented in certain places, and I just don't think that's going to take away the joy of the box for me. I love it, and I'm totally fine with that. So I'm not sure when I'm going to start this, but I'm really eager to start it. But I'll just show you the fabrics. They're definitely not my typical colour palette, but I'm excited by that. I'm excited to make something that's a bit different, but I do love them. So they are more along the reproduction fabrics, really, but that's what they are. So there's some browns in there. They're pretty florals, and each fabric is named after a character in the story. So what I think I'm going to do is listen to the story on audiobook whilst I'm making this, and I'm hoping that the making of this and the audiobook will be the same length of time, because that wouldn't that be lovely? So that's my plan for that, and I of course will show you any progress I make on that. But just a quick note, if you did want to buy that kit, I'm pretty sure it's still available in certain places, and I know of other websites that are selling it at a reduced price because of dented boxes and things. So you will be able to find it, I think, if you search for it. You do get a lot of fabric in it, and the finished quilt, let me see what size it is, 64.5 by 64.5, so it's a decent size. So yeah. And two more things to share. A lovely friend sent me this book as a gift, which I'm so grateful for. I don't know if you've ever seen this before. It's called Lovely Little Patchwork by Kerry Horsley. And honestly, it is lovely little patchwork. This book has so many things in it that I really want to make. She has some hexagon projects in there as well. Sewing cases, just things that are right up my street like this. But I think the thing I'm going to make first is going to be the spring flowers table runner. So I'm really keen to make this sort of tulip shape patchwork. So I'm excited to give that a go. I think I'm going to make that quite soon. I'm not sure which fabrics I'll use yet, but I have plenty to choose from. So yeah, big thank you to the lovely person who bought this book for me. I'm really excited to get making from it. I think that's going to be one of the next things that I do. Oh, I just saw it also has patchwork pumpkin and maple leaf placemat. Well, isn't that just perfect? And that might actually be the first thing that I make. I don't have any orange fabric, so I might have to get some. But yeah, I definitely want to make some autumn themed things, so I didn't realise that was in there. So that's perfect. And then the other thing I got recently was this book. So this is the Vintage Flower Sampler Quilt, and it is by Atsuko Matsuyama. I hope I'm saying that correctly. It's a really lovely book, and I'm really keen to actually make the sampler quilt. I love sampler quilts because they really keep your interest. So yeah, I'm keen to give this one a go. I have some fabrics that I think are going to work really well with it. And I know I started the Farmer's Wife sampler quilt, but I have just put that one to one side, and I think I'm going to give this one a go. It's smaller. A bit of a less intimidating project, although some of the blocks are a bit intimidating. But there's a mixture of applique and normal patchwork, so yeah, I'm keen to give that one a go. So I'll let you know if I do start that. Probably won't start that just yet, since I seem to have quite a lot of projects in the works for fun. But yeah, that's it for today. I hope you liked seeing what I've been making and hearing some of my plans. Do let me know in the comments what are you making at the moment, and what are your plans for things that you want to make leading up to Christmas. I'll definitely do another video about Christmas makes a bit nearer the time. But I am dreaming up some autumn projects as well, so there might be a video about that one day as well. But I'm also going to get back to my Quilt As You Go quilt, and there'll definitely be a video about that. That might be my next video, actually, because I want to make quite a lot more blocks for that and make some progress on it. So that's all my plans, really. So thank you so much for being here, and I will see you soon. A big thank you to everyone who is supporting me on Patreon. That really means so much to me and really helps me to keep going in creating content. And a big thank you to everybody who's pressed the super thanks button here as well. It's so kind and generous and very much appreciated. So until the next video, take care of yourselves. Happy stitching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.